In this installment of the TotalMix FX Beginner's Guide, I will show you how you can enhance your TotalMix FX workflow by customizing your user interface. But before we start, please make sure that you subscribe to our channel and that you also click on the notifications button to get all the future updates on the RME audio channel. Now let's switch over to TotalMix FX and look at the user interface in detail. TotalMix FX is great for customization. For example, I can rename every channel that I have in TotalMix FX. I just click on the top of the particular channel and I can rename them. In this case, I named both of the XLR inputs of my Babyface Pro, Mic 1 and Mic 2, because normally I use them for microphones. And if you want to have the default names of the channel, you can go under Show and then Names. And here you can see that we switch between my custom name and the default name. Another great thing is that we can minimize each channel to save some space or to get a better overview. So if I go on the bottom of each channel, you see that we have this little arrow. And if I click on the arrow, the channel is being minimized. If I click on the little arrow while holding the command button, all the channels on the right side of the selected track and the selected channel are getting minimized. So, very good shortcut for changing the layout very quickly. Another powerful feature of TotalMix FX is the ability to hide channels. If I go to Options and click on Channel Layout, I get my channel layout overview. So let's put them side by side. And as you can see, I have my Inputs tab, my Playbacks tab, and my Outputs tab, as you would find on TotalMix FX. And now, if I click on one of the tracks, I have the option to hide the channel in the mixer and matrix view. So if I select all these channels together and click on hide, you see that just my first input is shown. But, and this is important, we just hide the channel. The channels itself are still working in the background. This is just a channel layout for you to have, let's say, a better overview of what is currently going on. So I made some layout presets myself and I saved them here under layout presets. If I click on the store button and I say, okay, this is a layout that I find quite useful, I can just simply save it in my bank 4 here, in my layout 4. I can, of course, name them as well by clicking on the name, and I can say this is a new layout, and then I have my new layout saved. So as you can see, I have several layouts and I can just click them and I have drastic changes of my graphic user interface, of my graphical user interface. And this comes in handy for a lot of different reasons. Let's say you have one of our interfaces with over 100 channels and you just want to see some particular channels of, let's say, a drum booth that you record right now. Then you can select all these channels together in a channel layout and switch them over and say, okay, I just want to see the drums for right now. So you have the choice and the power to customize the user interface very easily and very drastic. Hope this was helpful. See you next time on the RME Audio Channel.